Today we're looking at a solid inverter that doesn't blow my mind, but for the price, it doesn't need to. This right here is a super quiet, affordable, and great for beginners unit. This is the Rich Solar RSH 3000 watt all-in-one off-grid inverter. So welcome back to the lab, guys. Today we're gonna be taking a look at this little guy right here, running it through some basic tests, telling you guys everything we don't like and everything we do like about it, and trying to find out if this is the inverter for you. And as you guys know, here at the lab, our opinions cannot be bought. We will leave some links down below if you guys want to check this thing out. We have a coupon code for you guys to use as well. We finally made it into the big leagues. You guys are always bugging us for discounts, and we are finally starting to get them to pass along to you guys. But before you go ahead and pull the trigger, let's jump into a super quick 60-second spec teardown for everyone that's not already familiar with the Rich Solar 3K inverter. First up, this little guy weighs about 23 pounds, so it passed the tiny baby lift test, no problem. It's a single phase 120 volt unit. You can run 240 if you run more than one of these units, and you can have up to six of them run in parallel, which will give you a total of 18 kilowatts of output. Each individual inverter is 3000 watts of output with a 6000 watt surge, and they're rated for 93% efficiency. This has a really impressive 4500 watt solar input, but it has a working voltage of 60 to 115 VDC. It's got an 80 amp max solar charge and a 40 amp max AC charge. You obviously have your two mounting brackets up top right here. Your screen and navigation buttons are all very central and easy to access. This unit doesn't have any kind of dedicated filters. Instead, it has this perforated metal kind of at the bottom, at the top, across the back. And coming down to the bottom, you obviously have your breaker, you have your AC input, your AC output, ton of parallel connection ports, Wi-Fi USB options, generator options, you have your solar input, and then you have your DC input. And behind the door on this guy, everything is directly in your face. And you can get all of this right here for $899 or $499 on Shop Solar's website. They have it on like a permanent massive sale. And at that price, this thing is a sweet deal. Jumping into some of the things that we really like about this Rich Solar 3K inverter. Obviously, I love the price. The price is insane. When you're looking at other 3000 watt inverters from an actual reputable quality brand, at $499, this is like the cheapest or one of the cheapest ones out there. At the time of filming, at least, this is definitely the best bang for your buck inverter. And I think the thing I like about this the most is that it's so quiet. Literally, we have the brother to this unit on the wall right here, right now, and it's running. It's on. You can't hear anything. Dead silent. And I absolutely love that about these. That just, for me, opens up the versatility of where you can use these, because you could put this like in your RV, you could put this in your bedroom and you're not gonna hear it. It's not that loud. Even other cheap and well-known products make a lot more noise than this guy does right here. Even when it's running at like 50% of its rated capacity, compared to the EG4 3000 watt inverter, this thing makes almost no noise. I also really like the 4,500 watt solar input. That is a lot bigger than a lot of other options of this size inverter. That means if you have it paired to two 5,000 watt batteries, you can basically charge your battery bank in just over 2 hours. I also really like that you can have up to six of these units parallel together. Sounds like a lot, and it's gonna take up a lot of wall space, but if you're just getting into solar and you buy one off-grid inverter and you just mount it up on the wall, you got 3,000 watts, you wanna start running 240, you buy another one, they're super cheap, and you have the ability to grow with a unit like this. You're not gonna have to try to sell this one to get a better one or whatever. And the last thing that I really like about this unit, even though underneath this faceplate is extremely daunting, it's very easy to set up. There's not a lot going on with these small little all-in-one inverters. It's really, really simple to get going. We'll cover it a little bit later in the video. It comes with a user manual, and that manual is actually helpful, and it tells you everything you need to know. And it's also very straightforward. If you just take this thing and literally lay it down, and just start looking at it, take the plate off, you'll understand where everything goes. They could have made it a little bit cleaner, but it's very, very straightforward. There is, though, a few things that we don't love about this unit. And the first one, like I already kind of talked about earlier, is that this is extremely intimidating and kind of messy. If you're new to this at all, looking underneath this faceplate could be very, very daunting. It isn't hard to set up. It is a little hard to access some of these back, like your AC out screws. They're behind two wires, or if you push the two wires underneath to get them out from behind, now they're in place of where the two wires go up and in. It's annoying to set up. Like, I'm frustrated trying to get wires in that back port, you can do it. And once you're set up, you really shouldn't need to unplug the stuff. So it's like a one-time pain in the ass, but it is a pain in the ass. As well as mounting this thing, you put screws through the inside here. They're not like an external little plate underneath, like something like the EG4 inverter is. This one, you put the screws through where all this daunting stuff is. And again, that's just frustrating because a lot of people don't have all of the tools in the world. And if you don't have a long enough screwdriver or a long enough drill bit, something like that, it's actually hard to get your screws into the wall when you have to kind of dodge everything else that's going on in there. I also just am not a fan of this like nut and bolt style battery terminal connection. Again, it's just like more work than it has to be. A lot of the other units, you can just kind of shove that battery up. I get that this is probably more secure, probably not gonna go anywhere, but as long as you properly mount this to the wall, it shouldn't go anywhere. Anyways, it just again comes down to like everyday people having the right tools to do these kind of jobs. Kind of frustrating to get these. I always hate them, and I wish I could just have a simple little slide-in port and be done with it. And the next thing that I just don't love about this unit is kind of funny because it's the reason that I like that it's so quiet. This unit has no air filters. And while you might not think that that's the biggest deal in the world, it's got the perforated holes right here. It obviously sucks air in from everywhere. That's great. But if you are a handy person or you like doing stuff or you know, like literally just cutting a piece of wood in your garage while this is running in your garage, the sawdust is gonna get sucked into the unit and start layering up inside of there. And so a unit with air filters just prevents that. It helps extend the longevity of the thing that you just spent a good amount of money on. And I love to see air filters, but I also do love the quietness. So it's kind of like give and take. If you're gonna run this in a pretty clean environment, I wouldn't worry about it. I would actually recommend this one because it's quieter. But if you're gonna be running things in a dirty environment, no air filters. When it comes to setting this thing up, regardless of it being daunting or not, it's actually pretty easy and really straightforward, but there is a very specific order that you have to do everything in because of the way it's kind of layered inside. So you have your AC input screws in front of your AC output screws. So if you just start doing stuff, it's not gonna go super smoothly. But we found it pretty easy to set up, and we started by just throwing two screws in the wall and easily hanging this thing on those two screws. The tricky part is getting a drill bit long enough to actually fire the screws through the bottom portion. Once I had it mounted up, I went ahead and I started with the AC output, since that's the furthest one in the back to wire in. We have this wire going down to two little outlet box with two 120 volt plugs. Then we wired our AC in. We actually have this wired to a little cut off extension cord that we could just easily plug the 120 volt into our house. And then that runs, the other end of the extension cord runs into here and gives us kind of like a grid power with an off grid inverter. Then I moved over to the right side, threw on my two battery connections. They're a little bit finicky to get up and then bent and around and on, but it's, you know, once you're done, you should be done. So it's not terrible. And then you're gonna go ahead and fire your solar input in last. Obviously, if you have more than one unit, you're gonna wanna run parallel connections from these connections over to the other units. Depending on the battery setup you have, you could run a USB from here over to your battery, but that's pretty much it. I think it's a really simple install. It takes absolutely no time. I just wish that there was less like kinking of the wires required. You kinda gotta like, again, even for like the solar input, it comes in the bottom, but the terminal is over here. So the wire has to come up and turn and go up like really janked. Again, like, I did it, no problem. But there's gonna be people out there that have no experience and don't wanna break things and whatever, and it's gonna be difficult for them. All in all though, I'd say probably solid 7 out of 10 for install. And once we had it installed, it was time to do some testing. So the first test I wanna know is how much does this thing consume on idle? Just sitting there plugged in. Obviously there's standby modes, you could turn the inverter off and whatever, but when it's just sitting there with power ready to go at my 120 volt outlets right here, how much power is this thing consuming? And we saw on the battery that it was using about 90 amps just sitting there idling. And I'm gonna give that to the fact that the fans aren't running that much. It's a little bit more efficient than some of the other units. It's taken about 46 watts to just idle. So doing absolutely nothing, you're using 46 watts of power just to keep this bad boy on. When it comes to idle consumption, it's not terrible. In terms of load test, this is a 3000 watt inverter. I actually ran it just over 3000 watts for 15 minutes. It was perfectly fine. Everything went well. There was no, didn't fuss about it at all. So that's good news. I always like running inverters just a little bit over the 3000 mark, just in case you miscalculate what you're trying to do. If you guys don't know how to do the math, volts times amps equals watts. So if you're trying to figure out like, is 3000 enough for me? Do the volts times amps for everything that you're trying to run at one time, and if it's under 3000 watts, then this guy could work for you. And probably one of the biggest tests that I like to find out with units like this is pass-through. Now, basically, if we have this connected up to our battery bank, and then we have something plugged into the plugs and the battery dies, obviously, because this is an off-grid inverter, we have nowhere else to get power from, everything's off. But if we have 2000 watts of solar outside in the sun, bringing 2000 watts into this unit, and we're trying to run a 1000 watt load, can you run the 1000 watts and then pass the other 1000 watts along to your battery? You should be able to. Most inverters should do this, but some actually don't. So we went ahead and tested this out with both AC and solar. And in both situations, you are able to have this, for example, plugged into the wall, which would replicate like a generator. If it's cloudy, you don't have solar, but you ran out of batteries and you're at a cabin, you could run a generator, run your power into this unit, and this unit will pass that power along through to whatever you have plugged in. And for the test, I literally shut the breakers off on the battery and on the inline fuse. So there was absolutely no battery connections at all, which is good. That's something that is really important. Like I said, if you're at a cabin or something and you show up, your batteries are dead, you can either rely on the sun or a generator or something to make sure that everything still functions. The sound test, we've already talked about that a lot. Obviously it passed, it was great. And the surge test, I ran this thing at about 4,000 and it ran for about 5 seconds. Nothing impressive, but it's good to note that it does surge up above beyond the 3000 like it says it does. At the end of the day, this is actually a really solid little inverter. We were pretty impressed with it. If you guys still aren't sold, if this is the inverter for you, or you want to pair it with panels or batteries or something like that, I would recommend calling a company like Shop Solar. I mean, you can just go online and look at packages and whatever that they have. We have a link to them down below as well as a coupon code, but you can go ahead, just give them a call and they will point you in the right direction of pairing this with batteries, panels, whatever. That is all I got for you guys. I will catch you guys in the next one. Thank you guys so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.